I know that in my last study tip video I said that we all study differently, and so you can take the tips that you want and leave the tips that you don't, but this one you're gonna wanna sit down for. I feel like this is something that everyone needs to absorb. Open book studying. Now this might sound a little bit dumb because obviously you have to study with your books, but I feel like when it comes to doing practice problems, very often people go into it with the mindset of, I've done my studying, I've read through the material, now I must close this material, open up my practice problems, and if I don't know how to do my practice problems, well, I just get the problem wrong and I move on. While this is fine and good, all it does is tell you which type of problems you know how to solve. It doesn't help you solve the problems you don't know how to do. Personally, for an actuarial exam that I studied 4 months for, I probably stopped doing problems open book 4 days before the exam, and I don't study the day before the exam, so I'm really using all my notes up until the end. If you're thinking something like, how will I know if I know the material if I'm always using my notes up until the end? To that I would say, if you're off notes 3 weeks before, you have to maintain that level of knowledge for 3 weeks. Like, that's a lot of time to remember tiny details. The way that I approach practice problems is, first, I will try to do it without my notes. If I can, amazing, I can just solve the problem, get practice, check the solution, move on. If I don't know what to do, I will go to my textbook, go to my study notes, go to my formula sheet, and try to use materials that I have available to me to solve the problem. Step three is, if I can't find the solution in the notes, which happens sometimes, then I'll look at the solution and try to do the problem with the solution. Even if it's something like a short written answer, I'll often read the solution to the point where I understand it, put it to the side, and then try to replicate it, which you'll be surprised, or you won't be. I'll read solutions, be like, that makes perfect sense, go to write it down, and I can't write a single thing and I have to read it again. Give this video a thumbs up if you too very often read something, understand it, and then forget it 7 seconds later. Story of my life, you guys. I think that the biggest advantage of this method is that it forces you to skim through the material a ton of times. Like, if your go-to is, I don't know how to do this problem, I'm gonna look at the solution, then all you learn is how to solve that one problem. But when you're reading through the material, skimming through the material, trying to find the solution, you're not just reading the answer to that question. You have to figure out where things are in the text. And at first, this can be really hard and you can't find anything, but having skimmed it 70,000 bajillion times, you start to put things together, your brain starts to pick it up, and it just makes things click a lot. What I like to do is, if I come to a problem and I'm skimming for the solution and I'm having a ton of trouble finding it, maybe not the first time, but if I see this as a recurring theme and I still can't find it, what I'll do is I'll either highlight a keyword in the text to make it more visible to me, or put the keyword in the margin. If you have trouble finding the section in the text talking about bears eating honey, then once I find it in the margin, I'll just write bears eating honey, and then I can read the whole paragraph the next time, and it just makes it easier to find it the next time. Like, my goal is always to make next time skimming easier. I just want my brain to be able to find the material really fast. Another thing that's really key is, if you're doing math type problems, which if you're watching my channel, you probably are, have a formula sheet. And if you come across a problem with a formula that isn't on your formula sheet, add it. If you use a formula that's on your sheet but you use it wrong, if I accidentally use a plus instead of a minus, I will go in and I will circle that minus and I'll be like, pay attention to this. If you're always forgetting the divide by whatever section, highlight that in your formula sheet. Tell your brain, don't forget to do this, because that's what you gotta do. I know that I learn the best by doing. When I do a million practice problems, it helps me so much. I mean, that's not a secret. I didn't invent the idea of doing practice problems. I'm just trying to tell you guys, do your practice problems. Let me know one of your study tips in the comments down below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to see more of my face. I'm gonna be putting out study tips and videos about actuaries and just random nonsense about actuary related things. And maybe I'll put out stuff about my life, but that would be on my LOL vlog channel and not on this channel. So, you know, you're not gonna see that on here. But I love you guys and thank you for calling. Bye.